Now I'm going to show you some examples of how I configured my Stream Deck XL with the SuperSource animations and just some examples. We are switching over from this view one, which is in fact camera one, to the SuperSource. Four boxes. If I want to show now box two, it's an animated transition back to four box. When I go to cam three, I have to watch now and then my preview monitor, which is in fact in input six. I can show you how that looks like. That's this one. And now we are going back to the four input SuperSource, and I can switch to, let's say, a three input SuperSource, just three boxes. And at the same time, I can show you like that in this monitor. I'm again on a page in which only these three boxes can be animated. So you won't make a mistake if you want to go from camera one to camera two. There is no camera two. It's one, three, and four, and that's the boxes, how they are configured. When I want to go back from this three box SuperSource, I can push this button, 1, 2, 3, 4 to 1, 2, 3, B. And in fact, if you want to know what these figures mean, what these numbers mean, what the layout looks like, I've made some templates, which I'm going to show you right now. Like that's template 16. So I'll see if I can get there. One sources 16 is this box. And when I go to, let's see, the other one, the layouts, have to go back to my SuperSource. I have to change the layout of box four, which will be number two, and I set that to 18. So I go back. Four is going to be media player two, and now you can see that the transition from this. And now I can go transit to the four box like that. That's an example when I want to show you what I'm doing right here. I can push just one button when I go from two to box four. And it's different from, it differs from the switcher on the panel, which are actually the inputs of the several cameras. And this is just the input of a box which you predefine before you are going to make your SuperSource layout. You predefine your boxes, what input is coming into that box. So now we are in the SuperSource mode. You can see on the switching board that SuperSource is on air, so I'm not confused that it is in fact camera two which is on air, because camera two, as you see here, is green and is in the preview mode. So in the program mode, I can show here on input six. Let me go back. No, I can't show that here. You have to take my word for it. Camera two is defined in the SuperSource box two, which is logic. Okay, so from box 2, I want to go to box 4, and then I push this button, and there is a sort of an animation. It differs from the switch of the switcher itself. When you cut from cam 2 to cam 4, it's a hard cut or a soft cut with the auto effect. But here it's an animating effect, the transition between the four boxes you've predefined and, well, designed. Let's go back. This is number 4, so I'll go back from box 4, I should say, to my layout. Here we are again. And now I'd like to change the layout to, let's say, a 2-box layout. So I go from here to here. Well, that's an example. Or from this is 1-2H, which means cam 1, cam 2, half full. There is another one. 1-2, let me go to this one, 1-2H, that's where we are right now. I can go to 1-2-3. Or I can go from 1-2-3 to 1-2-3-4. Or I can go from 1-2-3-4, and this is in fact 1-2-3-4-A. I have two different layouts, to 1-2-H. And then I can go to cam 1, or I can go back to 1-2-H and go to cam 2. Well, those are the different settings. 1-4-2, I can do square boxes. I can go to, let's see, back to cam 2. I can go to 1-4-2. I can go to, let me see here. Oh, that's 1-4. I can go to, let me see. This is box 1. I can do 4-1. So I put it in a reverse mode. On the left, the presentation. On the right, the presenter. I made this different choice because sometimes a presenter like here is looking to the left, and to the left you're looking out of the screen. So in fact, it would be better to have the layout mirrored. So we should go to input 1, no, box 1 on the left and box 2 on the right. So I'm going back to this layout, which is in fact better because I'm not looking out of the screen, but it looks as if I'm looking to my own presentation when I'm talking to my audience. Those are just a couple of examples which I made in this SuperSource layout together with the Stream Deck XL. If you want to know more, please subscribe to my channel. There is coming a lot more just to help you guys setting up your Atem Extreme, Atem Mini Extreme ISO. The ISO is the one I have here. And setting up your Stream Deck. We'll go through each step, step by step. And well, in fact, I'm looking forward to hearing from you. Until the next video. Bye.